Hi! Today I have for you a nice Imperial The Good Companion Model T. I got this thing relatively cheap. It looks to be quite okay, just very dirty, and I also do spot a lot of rust signs. So yeah, I'm gonna need to take this thing apart. First thing I want to try to do is take the shell off, and we'll take it from there. First thing I need to do now is get those spool out. Not too difficult. Let's put it on red setting. That's not red, that's blank. Okay, here's red. Let's get those spools out. One side. Here comes the other. On your dirty little ribbon. That's that. Let's sit on the side. Let's look inside over here. So one thing I noticed is, I turn this around, I should be able to get the lid off just by removing these things. It's just a metal bar that makes up the hinges. What I also noticed is that if you look over here inside, it looks as if the entire body is just kept together with these two screws, two on each side. In the back over here, there is another screw. A bit difficult to see, but it's there. And then on the other side, let's see if I can just make this. Oh, this one. Come on. Oh, that still works. On the other side, we also have this ribbon reversal switch, but I also already found out I can just screw that thing out. There we have it. That's easy enough. Let's put it in the box. We'll deal with that later. Funny thing I noticed is that there's actually a piece of wood in there on both sides. So what I'm gonna do first now is drench all those screws in some WD-40, some penetrating or other penetrating oil, but WD-40 is the only thing I have with me at the moment. So that's what I'm gonna use to make sure these come out a bit more easy. There we go. I'm gonna wipe off the excess. No need to make it dirtier. Necessary. So over here we have another one. Come on, just a bit. There we go. That's soaking. We have the other two screws. Great, that's that. Then that button's removed. I also noticed that the carriage lock is going to be in the way as well. So let's try to remove that one too. There we go. Let's move it aside. This thing over here should be fairly easy. It looks like it's just a pivoting screw. Let's make this a little bit easier to remove as well. very easy. That's nice. There we have it. That's underneath that thing. That slides on. Okay, great. Put that, those two pieces in a box. Here we go. And now let's move on to the main body removal. Well, I hope this is going to be easy, but you never know. First time I encounter wood in a typewriter. Ooh. Hope that doesn't give me too much heartache or difficulties or whatever. This one, lock screw. Alright, paper for that as well. Tag it and box it, so we can't screw up in that department. That's this one. There we go. Two similar screws. Maybe it's just this bit that's gonna come out soon, we'll see. Because it overlaps a bit over here. Maybe I'm wrong, eh? It's always possible. Yeah, I can just take that out. Oh, that's nice. Now let's get to the other screws. And then we take that off. The entire... ribbon cover. There we go. Just pops off now. Oh, come on. Oh, easy as shit. Oh, look, it's held in place. A little metal thing. That's nice. It's very nice. Otherwise, it's gonna be a pain to get it in place. Now, I thought that would be the entire body construction. Let's see. Yeah. If I can move this a bit, probably I can't. As you can see, there is a separate section over here. So now the question becomes, how do you get the wrist out? And I'm assuming that's just a matter of getting the back screw out. And then I think we might be in business. Let's see what happens when I remove this thing. Let's hope I don't break it again. Oh, come on. There we go.
Do you want to come out? Yeah, you want to come out. I know you want to come out. Come on. Same screw. Let's see. Yep, same screw. There we go. Now I'm hoping this thing just pops out. And no, it doesn't. Of course it doesn't. That would be way too easy. Well, at least I got the ribbon cover off, so that's good. Now I'm gonna need to find out where on earth this thing is still clinging on. I'm gonna move you guys a bit up to get a bird's eye view. Gonna remove these pieces of wood for a second. Let's see what we can find underneath the typewriter, where it could still be stuck somewhere. Moving up. It did move a bit already, so I'm guessing it can get out. Maybe I thought these bottom things over here don't do it. Did they squat? But I think I'm mistaken. I'm gonna put some WD-40 on those two, and then we're gonna remove them. So, let's put you guys like this, and give you some better lighting. There we go. It's one, it's two, and three, and four. Down, there you go, and grab some additional screwdrivers with a bigger bit size. Go out on a limb, I'm gonna assume it's gonna be this one over here. Let's see if this fits. This one. So out. All right. Very nice. Let's loosen up. Now let's loosen this one up. In there, you want to be in the center. I don't want to damage these screws. Oh, it's coming off rather nicely. Yeah, that's great. Just gonna go like this. One screw, oh, here is the other. Come on, get in there. And there's the other. Right. Now let's do the same on the other side. Oh shit, that's not good. So that comes from over there probably. I guess I did miss something. And now it's all coming out. Yep, that was it. That was the thing that kept this thing together, these four screws as well. Light bulb. See if I can just get it out like this. Nope, I'm gonna get my trusty wrench again. side. Now it's coming off. Get in there. There we go. Let's put it aside. And now we should be able to get it out of its shell somehow. Already noticed that's the that doesn't do anything anymore. Let's see. Here we go. It's very loose now. It's stuck on the space bar. Let's see how we can manage this.
Turn you around for a bit. Let's see, over there like that.
I don't want to bend this shit. That is destroyed, of course. Okie dokie. What are we looking at here? I need some more light. This board is stuck under there. We're gonna need to jiggle it a bit to get it out. Do I need to move it to a side or something? That's annoying. Let's see. Sometimes getting these things off their shells is fumbling. Nothing I can do about that. Okay, maybe I have an idea, but it's gonna be an annoying idea. Let's put you down like this again. Let's make sure I don't lose any of those screws. I've noticed that over here behind the spacebar there are a few screws that I might be able to get out. Oh my god, that's gonna be a pain in the ass to get to. Can't even see them. Right, let's see how I'm gonna be able to manage that. Let's first get some WD-40 in there. One screw. Two screws. And now number three. On the other side. Now let's see if I can get there with a screwdriver. Trying to give you guys some angle that you can see something that I'm doing. Because these screws are in a... that's about it. That's about the best I can do for you. There's one screw. Now screw number three is over there. Number two. It's the middle one. Let's that's loosened, and now the last one is all the way on the other side. Behind the space bar. There we have it. Now it's just a matter of lifting it out. That's one. There's number two. Come on out. Why won't you come out? You're all loosened up. Come on. Don't be like that. Come on. Let's try the other one first, maybe. Magnetizing this a bit more. There we go. Good boy. Last one out from behind the space bar. Come on, why won't you come out? Don't be like that. Oh, here we go. We have it. Great. That should take care of that problem. Let's see. Now we have this out. Those two screws are from the space bar. And now, I think I should be able to just lift everything out. No? There we go. That's it. Almost it. Come on, don't chew off my fingers. Just come out, please. I promise you, I'm gonna clean you. Just for getting out. There we go. And that's how you remove the shell of an Imperial Model T. Good stuff. Yep, that's it. So, three screws in the front for the spacebar, two screws on each side for the those bottom plates, and then this screw in the back that I'm not completely sure of why they secured it on that rod, but I'll probably find out somehow. Also why there was a spacer in between there. It's gonna be really fun to get that back in place. Good stuff. Alright, that's this bit of this series, getting the shell off. Goodbye.